Latina, sister, student, woman. Hello, my name is Atzira Villeda, and these are all words that describe me. Yet I am most compelled by the final adjective. Maybe it is because of the strong women present in my life, outlining the curves and crevices of the long path of the life that lies ahead of me. Or maybe it is the weight of what it means to be a woman in the 21st century that compels me to identify with the term the most. After all, women throughout the past centuries have withstood countless acts of oppression and restraint, and it seems only fair that I honor their pain, struggle, and determination. Today, being a woman for some implies having to challenge the social norm of femininity, and for others, it implies having to comply with the social duties assigned to a woman. And there seems to be no area in between those two choices. The strong determination that there's in every one of us has led to progress. Women today have more economic opportunities. Less women are forced into marriage. And overall, we have more liberty over our bodies and actions. However, this progress has not guaranteed gender equality. Although certain practices have been deemed immoral and unjust, it does not imply that the mentality of each individual that contributes to gender disparity has changed. Society, although maybe not directly, continues to suppress and restrain women from being equal individuals. Many physical restraints, such as being allowed in the workplace, have been lifted, but our society continues to hold a psychological control over women. From advertisements to literature, we continue to see a general portrayal of women and their role in a modern world that outlines and defines who we are supposed to be. This limits our ability to express individuality, and thus many women continue being subjugated to toxic environments and relationships. Once the entire picture of our lives was drawn out for us, the only difference is now we are allowed to color and shade in between the lines that remain from those perfectly painted pictures. The problem is augmented in lesser developed areas of the world, where some women cannot leave their homes without the company of a male figure. This serves as a reminder to the global citizen that although our situation in our respective countries may have changed, we must not forget about those who continue fighting centuries of restrictive norms. We must show to each other what is not shown to us by the rest of society, solidarity and compassion. We must be there for each other. We must persist to live the psychological controls over our actions and grow to live not just as women, but as humans. We must continue demonstrating that the determination that those before us showed, so that in the future, the girls identifying themselves with the term woman no longer carry the weight of a pained and victimized individual, but rather correlate the term with liberty and serenity. Thank you.